So you've seen print and television both?
Seen newspapers, magazines and TV.
And TV. Okay, which do you like most?
I've got to say I like my job in Beijing the most. Simply because I was the reporter. You know, what I love to do is to go out and report and tell the story. And it's much more fun to be a reporter than to be an editor. You tell that to all the young people who want to get into journalism. There's nothing like being a reporter, and there's absolutely nothing like being a foreign correspondent. I think every reporter, every journalist should do that at least once in their life.
Foreign correspondent.
Yeah, it's the most amazing job.
And television vis-a-vis print or newspapers, what was that like?
I think they're two different mediums that accomplish two very different things. I think print is there to make you think.
Okay.
To inform you in a different way. Television exists
makes
to make you,
react.
You feel.
Okay.
But to make you feel. I think there are people who will use that to make you react in all kinds of ways. There's all kinds of manners in which the medium is controlled. And it's, you know, small things make such huge differences in TV. The way someone speaks, the music that you use, the intonation of
a
word.
It's like a production, basically.
It's a production, but it's also very easy to manipulate emotions.
And do you?
And yeah, I think that people do.
Do you consciously, not people, you, Jehangir Pocha, NewsX?
Yes, we do, but we try to do it responsibly. For example, if, say, Jagjit Singh dies, we want someone to feel something for a man who has built his life creating music for us. If there is a bomb blast, yes, we want people to feel something, but we try to be responsible about it. You don't want people to feel unnecessary anger. You don't want them to be riled up. There are television stations and individuals who thrive on that.
Okay,
you know,
such
whose whole reason they threaten.
You won't take names.
I mean,
take a name. What's the problem?
No, I don't, because you know, I don't want to. It sort of
we
gets
take untidy. Names on News Laundry. We're okay. Very blasé about.
But you know, I mean, I think they know who they are, and I think viewers know who they are.
Okay, you're calling me Arnab and Times now.
You know, I think Arnab's an easy target. I think, you know, because he's number
Barkhan,
one.
Barkhan, NDTV.
She's another easy target for
Sagar and IBN. Okay, I
think there is an idiom in television. In
idiom,
television,
okay.
A kind of a manner of speaking, if you like, or a manner of presenting the news, which has been established. At NewsX, we don't follow it, as you know. We try to give news in a different way. As Aamir Khan told me, aapka sur alag hai, you know.
Sur as in sur.
Yeah, you know, as in music, your tone is different. Your music is different.
Okay.
When you listen to NewsX, you hear a different music. And it's got to do with volume, it's got to do with intensity, it's got to do with... we don't do what the other channels do consciously.
Now tell me, news is going through a severe credibility crisis.
It is.
For a variety of reasons. A, it is this whole hysterical nature of television. Print has been compromised in various ways, even, you know, magazines like the Helka that had a huge amount of respect when it came to combating the establishment have been accused of, you know, compromising because they were
The Goa thing,
Yeah,
I was there.
So, although Shoma Chaudhary did clarify on that, but there is this credibility crisis.
Definitely.
In television.
Actually, all over the world.
All over the world?
Yeah.
Okay,
I think it started all over the world with 9/11.
Okay.
And the way the American media reacted to that event, I think it threw media into a crisis because...
But that was an ideological thing. Here I'm talking about...
No, it was much more basic. It was much more basic. The media did not know how to react in a moment of national crisis. Were we supposed to be American journalists or journalists? And that's something we fight with even today as a journalist. Are you a journalist or an Indian journalist? This comes up when you deal with Kashmir. It comes up when you deal with nationalism. It comes up when you deal with international
But
issues.
Those stories are few and far in between. I'm talking about the everyday exposés of, you know, such and such corporate house, like Vinod Mehta was here, and he said that not the Tatas don't advertise with them because of the Radia tapes. Tehelka was saying they have problems with certain corporate houses, they will not advertise. And the best thing that you can hope to do is that if they will not do a story that might compromise their promoter, someone else will. You think
I know
that
the Tatas well, and I think that they associate with things that that meet a certain standard. I think if they don't associate with a magazine or a newspaper or a group, I would assume that it's because of a certain standard. I don't automatically jump to the conclusion that there's a conspiracy. I think that, you know, we've become very reactive.
He's
bound to think so, you know, and perhaps I would too in his place.
Okay.
But I don't think life can be reduced to such simplicities. I think part of the problem is, I was on a panel yesterday with Abhijit Banerjee, you know, wrote Poor Economics, and one of the things he was saying is that we have devolved into a society that makes such simplistic, you know, conclusions all the time.
But sometimes we
try to... that is a big fault of television,
I would say. Sure, but often, don't you think we try to make things way more complex when they are, in fact, simple? It works both ways. I mean, sometimes, just in the interest of trying to be fair, you know, like when two kids fight and the mother will slap both, saying that you're also wrong, you're also wrong. Yeah. But sometimes there is an obvious right and there is an obvious wrong.
Look,
and even then we try
to...
In
India, everything you say is true in some form. Mm-hmm. But if you ask me, I would come down on the side of saying that what we lack today as a society in government, in the private sector, in business, in the media is rigor. Just good old-fashioned rigor. You know, the amount of work you put into something, the amount of detail you put into it, the amount of study you put into it is just missing. And I see that with my own new staff, and I keep cajoling them and, you know, pushing them and working with them to get a little bit more rigorous about what they do. I see this, you know, even with myself. I catch myself saying, don't fall into this trap. You know, I'm not on Twitter. Just now someone was asking me, why are you not on Twitter? And my sense was, you know, as someone who's in news, I don't want to give myself to making these offhanded, you know, one-line comments. I mean, it's terrific for someone else to do it, but I think when I speak, I should be a little bit more studied and have thought through what I'm saying a little
bit
more.
Which takes more than 142 characters.
And Twitter, you know, the instinct is, oh, it's, you know, on my phone, let me shoot off a reply, and that's when people get into trouble. And so I'm consciously not
like,
on Twitter.
Like Sohail Seth going to travel on Twitter.
Yeah, but Sohail Seth is a very different person. You know, it's a very different position. I'm very mindful of my position, not in a formal sense that I want, you know, to be the boss, but I'm very mindful of the responsibility I carry. That you can't just keep whipping out, in my position, a phone and, you know, giving one-line responses and retorts to people.